नमः शिवाय। वेलकम टू द क्लास। वंस अगेन वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द चैप्टर ट्रेसिंग चेंजेस थ्रू 1000 ईयर्स। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द ओल्ड एंड द न्यू रिलीजियन। इन दिस वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द चेंजेस एंड द डेवलपमेंट्स विच ओकर्ड इन रिलीजियन। दिस पीरियड ऑल्सो विटनेस्ड मेजर डेवलपमेंट्स एंड चेंजेस इन रिलीजियन और रिलीजियस ट्रेडिशन। Religion was often closely associated with the social and economic organization of local communities. During this period, important changes occurred in Hinduism. They included the worship of new deities, royal patronage of temples, and growing importance of Brahmanas due to their knowledge of Sanskrit text. This period saw the emergence of idea of bhakti. The teaching of Islam were also introduced through this time due to the arrival of migrants and merchants. Muslims regard the Quran as their holy book and accept the sovereignty of the one God, Allah. So, these were the some major changes or development which occurred in the religion. Now, let's we move to the next topic. Thinking about time and historical periods. Time reflects changes in social and economic organization in the persistence and transformation of ideas and belief. The study of time is made somewhat easier by dividing the past into large segments called periods. British historians divided Indian history into three periods, that is Hindu, Muslim and British. This periodization was based on the idea of that the religion of rulers. Few historians follow this periodization today, but most of the modern historians focus on economic and social factors, dividing history into ancient, medieval and modern period. During the medieval period, the societies of the subcontinents were transformed often, and economies in several regions reached a level of prosperity that attracted the interest of European trading companies. So here we have come to the end of the chapter. So let's conclude the chapter as we have covered all the points of the chapter. The major points which we have learned in this chapter are, first, that all things change with time and we can learn a lot from looking at the past. Next, historians learn about histories from old coins, inscriptions, style of architecture and written records. They also collect manuscript. The next major point which we have learned in this chapter are, when people move between countries or continents, they take their lifestyle and ideas to new places. This is how over time old religion, science, culture and traditions changes and become new ones. And the last point which we have learned in this chapter, that it is easy to understand history if we divide the past into large parts called period that have many things in common. So here we have done with the chapter. Hope you have understand the chapter. So in the next video we will start with a new chapter. Till then, take care of yourself. Namah Shivaya.